So welcome back. We hope you were able to have some tea or coffee and come back refreshed so that you don't go off to sleep. We are still in this Teachers Day week, and all educational institutions in India have been celebrating Teachers Day. It's a very interesting event that we celebrate in India, that and it exemplifies a kind of relationship between the teacher and the student that is not to be found in most countries in the world. So since we are in this Teachers Day, let me say that I personally and all of us in this team here are honored to be part of this course. We are honored because we see so much of enthusiasm on your part. We are honored because more than 25,000 of you have chosen to register for this course, which shows how much you're interested in learning, but also how much you respect the kind of knowledge and skills we have acquired and which we are trying to pass on to you. Professor Phatak, who gave the introduction earlier and who is the coordinator of this MOOCs course, he likes to say something about soft skills or personality development or workplace communication skills. He says these are not soft skills, these are life skills. And I must say that I agree with him, because what you're going to learn is going to stay with you for the rest of your life. But what you're going to learn is not just about acquiring a specific set of skills like calculation, mathematics, language, and so on. This is something much more even than the knowledge in your own specific subjects that you will be acquiring, you're already acquiring as part of the various courses that you're undergoing. So we are trying to go beyond complementing the knowledge that you already have and which will help you to get jobs in the future. So what we are trying to do in this particular module on workplace communication is that we want you to be part of a workplace which ensures dignity. We want you to be part of an organization which provides a space for you to grow, which helps you to achieve aims and objectives for everybody, even as you achieve your own goals. When I was young, like you, and like all young people, I used to believe that older people don't know much and we younger people know more than them. I used to wonder sometimes, looking at friends of my father and parents and uncles and aunts and so on, how did these people get jobs? Because they didn't seem to have much skills. Over a period of time, I realized what it takes to work in an organization. But we as a team want to alert you that the modern workplace is much different from what it was 20 years ago, 30 years ago. There's a lot of expectation from you. A lot of skills, a lot of abilities, a lot of knowledge is expected to you beyond the knowledge that you have of your own subjects. So these are not just soft skills that we are providing you. These are not just technical skills. We are not just talking about personality development, but perhaps we are talking about what can be referred to as person development or life skills for survival that Professor Phatak talks about. So we are interested in you as a person, as a human being who's going to be working with other human beings. So workplace communication is about addressing the issue of what kind of a person you as an individual are and what kind of a person you wish to be. How do you like to be seen by others, your co-workers? How can you acquire skills which will help you to take advantage of opportunities? I am reminded of a quote by our late president, Dr. Abdul Kalam, who said, "Not everyone in the world has equal talent, but everyone has an opportunity to acquire talent." Perhaps that's not entirely true, because not everyone has equal opportunity. But through this course, what we hope to do is to provide you that opportunity to acquire talent, which will stand you in good stead when you move from college to corporate. But it's not just about creating opportunities for each of you individually. So when you graduate and start your careers, how can you create opportunities for others? Because that is what distinguishes good human beings, that we are not just concerned about ourselves. How can we collaborate and associate with others so that we all can enhance the opportunities available for us so that we contribute to certain common goals and objectives of the organization, of society, of the family, and so on. So, as Professor Sethi mentioned earlier, this course is about honoring yourself, but it is also about respecting others, irrespective of who they are, what kind of background they come from, what kind of gender they belong to, what kind of ethnic, religious, language, regional communities they come from. So, it is something that is beyond what we are traditionally taught as teamwork. So, being a professional, being a human being you as an individual who is unique, who has certain unique abilities, experiences, backgrounds, skills, knowledge, and so on. So, each of you need to recognize what you can contribute to an organization, what you can become, both as a human being and as a professional. So, don't look at this course as a skills course. These are far too important to be recognized merely as skills, because what we are going to tell you is that these will help you to shape your visions for your future, your aspirations, your ideas, your strategies in the workplace, your strategies for you as an individual to advance your career goals. So, these will ultimately determine how we live our lives, how we can contribute to the groups and organizations we are a part of. So, Professor Sethi in the morning explained that we in this team are also learning how to do this. We are doing it for the first time in this particular mode. Since we are learning, we hope to keep this a bit flexible. So, we would like to also learn from you about what is your idea of workplace communication and other skills that we are going to impart to you. We would also like to learn from you what is it that you expect from this course. So, before we go ahead and give you an introduction to the topics that we are going to cover in the workplace communication module and explain about the assignments, activities, and so on, I would like to get your views on this. So, I am going to give you a minute to think about why you have enrolled for this college to corporate course. So, even before we come to workplace communication and think about what it means, I would like you to reflect on why you have enrolled for this college to corporate course. What do you hope to gain from it? So, please take a minute to think about it, and then I will come to some of you and we'll get a sense of what are your motivations in showing so much enthusiasm and in such large numbers to enroll for this course. So, please take a minute. Okay, I hope you have had the chance to reflect on your own motivations and the reasons why you have chosen to register for this blended MOOCs course on college to corporate, and maybe you have also had a chance to talk with your friends and partners. So, I am going to come to some of you and get your views, and hopefully we will use these in modifying and revising the program, both in when we are offering it right now and in future courses. So, can we go to 1021 Itanagar?
I am the student coordinator.
Okay, the coordinator. Okay. So, welcome. How many of you are there?
We are nearly 10.
Okay, that's very good. So, can one of you tell me why you have chosen to enroll for this course? What is your motivation?
To develop our personalities and to improve our communication skills.
To improve your communication skill, okay. Okay.
Maybe after talking up from here, we were particularly looking for a job.
Okay.
And to present how to improve our personalities, how okay. to communicate, how to interact.
Okay. So, how to interact, and you are going to be passing out very soon. So, how to get a job, how to interact, improve your communication skills. Anything else? Can you pass the mic to someone else? Yeah, please go ahead.
Okay, if it goes about the soft skill and communication skills. So, as we know today, very important to have those skills to survive in today's fast-changing world. We need to motivate to build those skills.
Okay. Thank you very much. So, you say that soft skills and communication skills are very important in today's workspaces. That's the reason why you've enrolled for this course. So, I hope, thank you for joining us from a very remote part of India, and we hope you make the most of this course.
Thank you.
Thank you. Can we go to 1094? Okay, Lord Mata College of Science and Technology, welcome. Who is the coordinator here?
Myself, I am the coordinator. So my name is Krishna Prashant.
Krishna Prashant, thank you very much for coordinating this. As Professor Sethi said in the morning, you will play a very important role. As the course progresses, there will be a lot of activities, assignments that you need to coordinate. So, we appreciate the support provided by all the coordinators. So, I would like to pose this question to your participants. Why have you chosen to enroll for this course? What is your main motivation?
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Myself, Anjali. Mainly four courses. First one is soft skills. So, I want to improve my soft skills, like how to communicate with others, how to address an audience with confidence, how to attend an interview.
Okay.
Then regarding face and all, how to communicate clearly within a peer group.
Okay.
And also, I hope that all this will be improved by completing this course.
Okay. So thank you very much. So you want to improve your soft skills and then you want to improve the communication with your peer group. Yeah. So are you already doing something to improve these skills?
Yes, sir. I'm trying.
You're trying. What are you? How are you trying?
Sir, actually, what I say that first we have attended one pre-course assignment regarding reading and all.
Okay.
So within that also, our communication has been changed. That is, within even our chat have been changed. We have started talking about certain books. We have started sharing about certain things, whether that's a good book or not, like that. So we are changing actually.
That's great to know that, you know, in such a short time, with just the first introduction and the readings, that you're already beginning to change in terms of exchanging more information and communicating and chatting and so on. And this is what contributes to mutual learning, because communication is not just conversations. Communication is about how we learn from each other. Okay, how we communicate something that we want to say to others, how those people absorb it, and then how they respond. So, we are very glad that you're already beginning to share. Does somebody else want to have a go?
Hello, sir.
Hello.
I just joined this course because we are all engineering students, and I think once in a life we have to work in industry, and this will be very helpful for us.
Okay. In what way do you think it will be helpful?
Regarding the communication, I think industry, the communications are slightly different. Not in a formal, I think it's in a formal manner, and not a casual manner.
Yeah.
So I think this is very helpful for us.
Yeah. Thank you. That's a very important point you are making, because we are very clear that this is not simply about acquiring English language skills. This is about communication in whatever language you wish to use in the workplace when you move from college to corporate. So you very rightly recognized that when you move to a career, the kind of communication you'll have to do will be very different from what we do in informal circumstances, whether at home or with your friends or even in other formal settings like the classroom. So there are very specific kinds of things that we need to learn how to do these things, and you will be at an advantage if you learn some of these formal mechanisms of communication that you will encounter in the workplace. So we hope you will maximize the opportunities from this course, and we wish you all the best for your future.
Thank you.
Thank you. Can we move to 1028? How many of you attending this course today? 90. Okay. More than 90. Oh, thank you. So you're not able to speak, is it? Some problem with communication. Okay. So maybe we'll move on. So good to see such a large number. Tatya Sahib Kore, I visited your college many years ago, and we were doing some very interesting research in Varnanagar. I'm very happy to see the students from Tatya Sahib Kore again. Hope to visit you sometime in the future again. But you have excellent infrastructure and an excellent campus. So I hope you also optimize the learning from this course, and you're able to have great careers once you graduate from here. Thank you. for joining this course. I'm sorry we are having communication problems. Yeah. So we've heard some of the reasons and motivations that students have given for joining this course, and I think there will be many more such reasons and justifications and motivations, and each of you will have some unique motivations as well, and of course there will be a lot of common justifications for joining this course. Now, beyond these motivations, what comes out from some of these conversations is that there are specific requirements that some students have, depending on what is your own background, what kind of skills you already have, what kind of strengths you already have, and what you think you need to acquire before you make a successful transition from college to corporate. But in order to translate that motivation into successful learning, you also need to be clear about what exactly soft skills is, what exactly communication is, what exactly workplace communication is. So I'm going to be coordinating this module on workplace communication. So there is going to be a bit of an overlap between the soft skills course and the workplace communications course. But we are also going to be addressing something very specific. So do you have an idea of what workplace communication is? Because all of you are still students, you will be moving to workplaces very soon. Some of you may go on to do your master's or PhD before you go on to your careers. So what is your idea of workplace communication? So I would like to give you 2 minutes to think about it, maybe discuss with your colleagues and partners who are sitting next to you. So I would like you to think about 2 things. What is your idea of workplace communication? And number 2, what is it that you want to learn as part of workplace communication? That is, what kind of skills you wish to acquire as part of workplace communication? So please take 2 minutes to write down responses to this. Okay, so I hope you had a chance to both reflect on what you understand by workplace communication, as well as getting to know what workplace communication means to your partners and colleagues sitting with you in your rooms. So can we go to one of the colleges and get to know your views on what workplace communication is, or what you expect to learn in this workplace communications course? Yes, Sinhagad, College of Engineering. Hi. Good to see an enthusiastic group here.
Hi, sir.
Hi.
Sir, my name is Kiran Patmase. I am coordinator for this program. And these are my students. They have been waiting for you since morning to interact with you.
Okay.
They have a lot more to share with you. So I would like to hand over the mic to my students.
So Kiran, thank you very much for having a very enthusiastic bunch of students.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Alisha. As we are learning workplace communication, mm-hmm. So in workplace communication, we are, so I think it is about the getting along with the people. So we are as in a college stage, we are going to the professional level. Mm-hmm. So in that, we need to go along with our juniors, colleagues, and our seniors also. So in this, we are expecting to learn that how to get along with the people, how to deal with the people, and as well as some interpersonal skills.
Okay. Alisha, thank you very much for that
yes.
observation. So, are you saying that you are not able to get along with people right now?
Actually, I'm getting along with my friends. But
okay.
When we are dealing with professional life, because
yes.
we don't have an experience, what will be there,
yes.
what is going to happen with us.
Yes.
So, we are... So we think to learn that.
Yeah, so that's an absolutely important point, because what you're saying is right
yeah.
now you're getting along with people as friends and people who have
yeah.
who are at the same level and similar learning objectives. But soon you'll be getting into professional life, people at different levels, skills, having different roles in the organization. So how to get along, the kind of interpersonal skills that you'll require, how to deal with people when you're doing different jobs. Those are the
yeah.
expectations that you have with reference to workplace communication. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
Can I have somebody else from the same college?
My name is Shobhanesh. So I think, sir, that workplace communication is the transmitting the information
mm-hmm.
between your colleagues or in the group or in organizations. It may be from the sources like mails or by sending them messages.
Okay.
I think this course may help us to develop our interpersonal skills in the corporate level, or how we can communicate or speak with the colleagues or professional workers.
Yes. Yeah. So thank you. So transmitting information, especially official information, between colleagues, that's an important set of skills that we are going to learn in this course. Do you have any idea about what kind of transmission of information takes place?
Sir, I think so that if a project is assigned to a manager or an engineer, he should try to explain it to the workers that how it should be worked or how it should be carried out. So it's more important that workers should know exactly what is the project and how we have to perform on it.
Yes.
So it may increase the efficiency of the work and the project will be brought out in good manner.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. We hope you all have a
thank you, sir.
Great time learning from this course, and we'll get back to you in the course of this this semester, next couple of months, we'll get back to you again. Thank you. Can we go to someone else? Bila Institute, Durg, welcome. So we seem to have more women here than men. That's a good sign in engineering college. Okay, can one of the coordinators speak, please?
I'm Swapna Sarkar, assistant coordinator.
Okay, so Swapna, how many students are there here?
200, sir.
200, oh, that's
200.
Fantastic. That's fantastic. All of them are in the same room?
In this room, 60 students.
Okay.
No, sir. In this room, 60 students. One is NCLM and the rest of the students.
Okay, that's fantastic to know that there are so many students who have registered for this. All of them are third year students?
Yes, sir.
Which year are they?
7th and 5th.
7th and 5th, okay. Yeah, one of the students, please respond. What do you understand by workplace communication?
Now we are in our college life and we are in our third year. So after our college life, we'll entering the corporate world. So there, the atmosphere of the corporate world is entirely different from what we are living in our college life. So workplace communication, we have to communicate with our colleagues or with our seniors. So in this, and I'll be expecting that we learn how to communicate in a professional way.
Okay.
And like if we have assigned some task, like a teamwork task, so how to do better in that. Teamwork or something like group task, etc.
Okay, so how to communicate in a professional way, that's what you want to do. Okay, can I please let me know your name?
Shivani Bhatia.
Shivani Bhatia, thank you for that.
Thank you, sir.
Comment. Yeah, so there are different kinds of corporate jobs, and each of them have a different idea of what is professional. So, depending in some organizations, it's okay to have casual communication, in some you need to be highly professional. So it's very important to understand what is the expectation of different organizations so that you can communicate effectively. So I would like you to focus on the second question that I had, that is, what is your expectation, what kind of topics that you want us to cover in this workplace communication skills course?
Until now, we have only gained knowledge regarding student life. Like, we know how to complete assignments or fulfill the deadlines. But we don't have any knowledge about what will happen when we get into something that is like, it's the world of jobs and works and corporate is completely alien to us currently. So I would be expecting that we would know how to adjust in that alien environment, as well as do well in that section. So that is all that I'd be expecting.
Thank you. Actually, the corporate life is not all as different from the student life that you expect, because you will still have deadlines. You will still have to complete assignments in time. Okay. So don't expect that you'll be running away from assignments and deadlines once you join the corporate life. Okay. It's not going to be easy. But yes, you're right. There are a different set of expectations, and as a professional, how do you interact with your colleagues? That's something. So it is alien in some ways, but it's also the same in some ways. Thank you very much for participating. St. Francis Borivli.
I am the coordinator of the course. My name is Paul Fernandez, and we have about 20 students attending this course.
Mm-hmm.
And we want to thank you for choosing the topic soft skills and workplace communication. And I believe the soft skills will help our students to crack their interview at the first level, and the workplace communication will help them to climb the ladder once they reach the corporate world. Okay. And now I would like to give to the students to share their experience and what they expect from this course.
When we know that communication is a key aspect for any institution to rise or fall, so we are eager to learn about the various other factors or external factors like seating arrangement of in the business place, like cuboidal structure, how they affect communication in professional world.
Okay, so you already seem to be a little bit of aware of how we sit in the in corporate offices. So yeah, how the spatial pattern, how we sit, how we are organized, how the seating arrangements are organized, they do affect how we work. And maybe your long-term aim is to get into that corner office. You know what a corner office is?
The boss.
The boss, the hierarchy. Yes. Okay. So, yeah, so this brings a new dimension to the workplace communication, because it's not simply about oral and written communication. It's there are a lot of factors that affect it, including body language, where we sit, what kind of mechanisms or technologies we use to communicate, whether it is face to face or through email or social media, through paper and so on. So there are a lot of dimensions which we hope to cover. Anyone else at the back wants to tell us what he or she expects from this course?
My name is Akshita Bhatt. I expect that we will improve our presentation skills and the way we communicate with the people. Mm-hmm. So we'll have a better confidence in facing the world, corporate world, and
okay.
So that's all.
Okay, Akshita, you already seem to have a lot of confidence.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, yeah. So that's what. So it's not that students are not confident; it's how you use that confidence in the workplace. Okay, that's what. So some of us lack in confidence for various reasons. Some of us have that inner confidence in us. Some of us are nervous internally, but we are able to project a very confident face to the outside world. So what we are trying to do here is to channelize, help you channelize that inner and outer confidence into effective communication. Okay? So we hope that you will benefit from this course. And please do get back to us through email and discussion forums if you have any further suggestions on what you want us to include in these courses. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much,
St.
Francis.
Sure.
Yeah. Just one more college maybe we can go to. RBS Agra, welcome. You seem to be a very large group.
Hello.
Hi. The way, you know, I like the enthusiasm of you people waving to me as though I am Shah Rukh Khan.
Namaskar, sir. Once again.
Namaskar.
Sir, myself, P.K. Singh.
P.K. Singh.
From RBS Engineering Technical Campus, Agra. The city of Taj Mahal.
Yes, of course.
So first of all, I would like to appreciate, sir, your initiative to groom various students throughout the country. Most of my students, would you like to communicate with you?
Yeah.
So I would like to give them chance.
Before we go to them, so Dr. P.K. Singh, you are the coordinator.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So you mentioned
P.K.
P.K. Singh. Okay. You said you are in the city of Taj Mahal. So
yes, sir.
Can you tell us how you can bring some romance into workplace communication?
My student can tell you better.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Please give it to one of your students. The students, you seem to have a very unromantic professor.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I'm Harshita.
Harshita
Dixit.
Yes.
So I was wanting to answer you what you were asking previously.
Yeah, please answer me.
Well, from this, I'm expecting to invent myself. As in the previous session, sir said, we have to invent ourselves here. We are already fab, but after this, we are entering to the professional world and we want to discover some new communication skills and all for that. So we are here for that.
Okay. That's what we are looking for in our students. When you said we are already fab, you know, that shows the confidence that you have. We believe that everybody is fab. Okay. But how can we make it fab plus? That's what we are trying to do.
Sir.
Okay. So I greatly appreciate your answer that you want to invent yourself. And that's what I tried to say at the beginning as well, that it's not just about giving a uniform set of skills so that all of you become like automatons or robots and behave exactly in the same way in the workplace. Each of you is unique. So how do you optimize that uniqueness? How do you bring that uniqueness to the workplace while also ensuring that you fit into the goals and objectives of the larger team in which you are working? So for that, you need to constantly invent yourself, reinvent yourself. So how do you reinvent yourself? Hopefully by the end of this course, you will be able to tell us that. Thank you very much for that answer. How many students are here in RBS Agra?
There are 266 students registered.
Okay. How many are here in the room? Everyone?
Almost every student is available.
Okay. Okay. We hope the others will join also. So, yeah, great to see such a large number.
Student would like to ask.
Yes. Yes, please.
My name is Kamran Ahmed. I'm a finalist student of mechanical engineering. My question is, how we can get sustainable growth with study? The study, growth of physical and mental with study.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for that question. Sustainability can mean many things. So I'm not sure which context you're asking this question in, but I'm, because of the nature of this course, I'm assuming that you're asking about maintaining a sustainable growth for yourself as an individual. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, precisely. That's what we are aiming for, because with your individual skills, ability and knowledge, you can only get so far when you join the corporate sector, when you get into a job. So there's only a certain distance that you can travel. But what we are hoping, and this is why I mentioned at the beginning, that this is not just about skills. It is about recognizing your own individual capability. It is about respecting the dignity of other people. So when we look upon work in the sense of dignity, we are thinking about how we can interact with each other as human beings in a sustainable way, which means that we want to go far ahead in terms of achieving our objectives, not just in terms of climbing the ladders. So recognizing your own individual abilities, your motivations, where you wish to be, what kind of a human you want to be, what kind of a professional you want to be. So what we are trying to do is to place you at the beginning of this journey, give you certain tips. Make sure that you know the path so that you can follow it. So the kind of things that we are going to talk about in this course will give you some specific skills, but we are also hoping that this will just be the beginning of a self-learning journey where each of you will chalk out your own path. You will be able to draw the route to your success yourself. That's what we are trying to do here. Okay, so we will not be here to hold your hand forever. So you will have to do this for yourself. And sustainability means that you don't necessarily depend on others to take you ahead in this journey. So that's a very interesting question, Kamran, and that is exactly what we are trying to do in this course. But if I can just spend a minute on the other meanings of sustainability. So in the beginning, I mentioned that we are not just talking about corporate success. We are talking about what kind of organizations we want to work in. So in today's world, it's very important that we also pay attention to other issues of sustainability with reference to the environment and ecology, what kind of development we want and so on. So hopefully these courses will also give you the values necessary so that you can channel the workplaces in a more sustainable way, whether in terms of energy or environment or sanitation or how you treat each other as human beings. Thank you very much for that question.
So much, sir.
Thank you. So we've had a very interesting and diverse set of responses about what workplace communication means to each of you, but also what you expect to learn from this workplace communication module. I'm sure the 25,000 of you will have many more thousands of different kinds of responses, and maybe you can share it with us through the discussion forum. So we've already shared this course outline with you, the outline of topics and the schedule. There's a slight change that is reflected here. but we will be making a few more changes. We were just discussing about it this morning. So please look for an updated schedule over the next couple of days. What I plan to do in the next few minutes is to briefly introduce you to workplace communications. So you already have a certain idea of what workplace communication is. You already have a certain idea of what is your expectation, what do you hope to learn, and what do you hope to gain from this course. So we released the introductory module last week, and we hope you've already started doing the assignments and activities that we have recommended for you, that you've also started reading the material that we have prescribed for you. Next week, we are going to release a video and related material on presentation skills. Of course, presentation skills is part of soft skills as well, but here in workplace communication, we are going to focus on something very specific. That is, when you join an organization, you will be either asked to make presentations or asked to prepare presentations. A key aspect here in today's workplace is that we make presentations which contain not only text material, but also images, graphs, pictures, data in the form of tables. So most of us are not formally trained in the use of these while presenting. So there are certain strategies for effectively making presentations when we create and use graphs, images, data, and so on. So Professor Ambarish Kumar, who is a faculty in the School of Biosciences here, is going to tell you about these, and an interesting set of learning material and assignments is going to be given to you for making these presentations. Because in today's world, we are not just communicating using text either orally or in written form. We use a lot of images, we use a lot of pictures. So images convey something in a better way, in a more efficient way, which text cannot sometimes. So it's very important that, and today we are also living in a world where a lot of data is used. This is the world of big data, this is the world of data analytics and so on. So it's extremely important, irrespective of which kind of jobs you take up, that you're also proficient in presenting data, images, pictures and graphs in very effective ways. One of the things about corporate life, and this is sometimes a boring part of corporate life, is that you have to conduct and participate in a very large number of meetings. But meetings are something that is uniquely human, and this is something that you have to recognize. So if you look at other species of living beings, not many of them have meetings like human beings do. So why do human beings have so many meetings? And why are meetings important? Because meetings are ultimately about the fact that we are social beings, that we like to come together, discuss and take decisions. So in corporate life, you will be expected to attend a lot of meetings. So it's important that we learn about etiquette, how to participate in meetings, when to speak up, when not to speak up, how to interrupt, how not to interrupt, how to make points effectively in meetings, how to make points without seeming to be very aggressive. So there are a lot of aspects which not only help us better contribute to meetings, but also improve the overall efficiency and outcome of meetings. So Dr. Lina Jha, whom you met in the morning, who's a communications consultant with us, is going to be teaching you, giving you some tips on these. And along with this, there is, as some of you have pointed out, a lot of official communication in the workplace. So these are both oral and written. So there are specific kinds of communication that we need to learn, because any mistakes in these kinds of official communication will send out wrong signals. They may also send out wrong signals about your own abilities. So this could be official letters, briefings that you prepare for partners or for clients or for government officials, minutes of meetings, notes that you put up to your seniors and so on. So there are specific formats and templates that different organizations use. Some of the software that we use also provide templates for these. But these are dependent on which organization, which sector you work on, whether it's advertising or finance or banking or manufacturing. They also depend on the kind of language that is used, whether you are using electronic media or paper communication, and what is the level of casualness that you are allowed to use in this communication in your own organization. So, official communication is one of the most important aspects of workplace communication, and again Dr. Lina Jha will be talking about this and giving you a number of activities and assignments, both group and individual, for this particular module. If you watch the introductory video, you will know that we are stressing on something that is very unique and specific to modern workplaces. So, the modern workplaces are global workplaces. That is, they are global because you may be working for a company or a firm which has a global presence around the world. You may be working for a multinational company. You may be working for a company which was started in some other country, has a branch in India. But it's also global because there is communication that is happening face to face, through travel or through technology, with clients, customers, partners, fellow employees from all parts of the world, from many different countries in the world. It can be global because we are using knowledge which is global, we are using technology which is global, we are talking about work itself which is global in nature because it is taking place in so many different parts of the world. At the same time, we are living in a world where gradually some of the older inequalities, prejudices are beginning to come down. So, the modern workplace will have more women, it will have more people from different castes, communities, religious groups, regions, people from many different educational backgrounds. So, this is seen as the strength of the modern workplace because it provides equal opportunities to everybody. But the modern workplace not only gives equal opportunities to everybody, they also try to capitalize on the unique experiences of everybody. So, men and women, people from different ethnic backgrounds, minority backgrounds, religious backgrounds, regions, will come with their own experiences. So, a lot of research in psychology and economics show that this diversity contributes to better ideas, more creativity to solve the problems in the workplace, and therefore, diversity in the workplace is something that is formally encouraged. But this brings with it its own unique problems, because not all of us have grown up trained to deal with this diversity. Some of us unconsciously may have biases, prejudices to others depending on gender and class and caste and region and so on. There are also specific kinds of language that we have to use because we are working in a global workplace. There are specific terms that we need to learn how to use. So, we are going to learn about how this global and cultural awareness can be used to modify our behavior, whether verbal, non-verbal, human gestures in the workplace, so that we all can work effectively without creating conflicts. This also brings me to a very important issue of workplace ethics, because a workplace, like every other space in society, also has politics. The workplace has different ideas of what is good and bad, what is the ideal thing to do, what is expected, what is acceptable. So, it's very important that we maintain integrity. So, some of you responded earlier that you wish to interact as professionals. You want to learn professional communication. To be professional also means to maintain integrity. Integrity is not just honesty, but a range of issues that we have to learn when we are dealing with different kinds of people and when you are contributing to common goals. So, maintaining integrity and how to conduct ourselves as professionals is something that I am going to talk about, and Professor Sir Rajesh Zele from IIT Bombay is going to give you some tips on this. So, Professor Zele comes with a lot of experience from industry over 20 years. And he also has experience in academia. So, he is going to say some very interesting and exciting things about professional conduct and workplace ethics. A key aspect which is also required by law is that certain guidelines relating to sexual harassment and workplace harassment be followed by every organization in India and around the world. So, there are institution specific guidelines and there are national guidelines given by the Supreme Court of India. So, most of us are good human beings. We don't harass others, but some people do. But some people may unconsciously or unintentionally involve in certain kinds of behavior which will be regarded as sexual harassment. So it's very important that we be aware of these guidelines, of these norms of what constitutes sexual harassment, what is not, so that we can then behave appropriately in the workplace. So this is very important because, as I said, the modern workplace is very diverse. Increasing numbers of women are in the workplace. It's very important that they do not feel harassed so that they can contribute as equals to the workplace. The last two topics cover non-verbal communication and email communication. So some of you have been talking about body language, attitude, behavior, and so on. So this area has expanded exponentially. There are a huge number of videos that you can get on YouTube, I'm sure, if you search for these. So apart from using language to communicate, we also use a lot of gestures, hand gestures, facial expressions, and so on. Now, not only do we have to learn how to use expressions appropriately, but we have to learn how to use these expressions in a global world. So there are certain kinds of non-verbal human gestures which we may use, which is intelligible, which we can understand within India. But if somebody comes from another country, he or she may not be able to understand this. So in a globalized workplace, what kind of human gestures to use so that our communication becomes effective? This is something we are going to learn. So Dr. Megashree Dalvi, who is also a communication consultant, is going to talk more about this. And finally, in the modern workplace where technology is used extensively in communication, we use email, but we also use a lot of social media, both formally and informally, Twitter and WhatsApp and a whole range of other applications. So some of these may divert us from our work functions, but some of these are also useful. So there's a lot of informal and formal communication that takes place through these. So we are going to learn, that is Professor Varsha Apte, who's in charge of the computer center in IIT Bombay, is going to help us maximize the use of technology in communication, what kind of etiquette is to be followed. At the same time, she's also going to alert us to some of the dangers of inappropriate use of social media and email communication, which can create a lot of problems. You need to be aware that these topics that we are going to cover are not simply about acquiring certain skills. I have mentioned to you earlier that workplace communication involves maintaining one's own dignity in the workplace while respecting the dignity of others. So your own honor is important. Respecting other people is also important. So there are a very large number of examples. You keep reading about them in newspapers and hearing about them on TV all the time, where in very large companies, people did not follow some of these basic etiquette, whether it is gender and diversity, global awareness, use of social media, and so on. Because of this, people have had to leave organizations, they've been sacked, they felt they didn't fit in, and so on. So while it is important to respect your own individuality, we need to respect the individuality of others also. In order to ensure this, organizations have come up with a number of guidelines, and just a quick browse through internet or on YouTube will give you a lot of workshops and guidelines on these topics, and you're very welcome to go through these. But beyond just learning how to communicate in the workplace, learning to work together as human beings is what we are trying to stress here. And that is why it is so very important that you both respect yourself and respect others when it comes to workplace communication. And I cannot stress the importance of this enough. Now, these topics, just to reiterate, are given in a particular sequence here, but there is going to be a slight change in the sequencing. There is also going to be a slight change in the dates. So the coordinators as well as the participants are requested to note that earlier we had decided to release all the modules on Thursdays, but they are going to be released on Tuesdays from next week. We will send you a formal communication about this, but each module will be released on Tuesdays and you'll have 1 week to complete them. Very quickly, I want to touch upon some operational issues relating to this course, similar to what Professor Sethi had told you in the previous module on soft skills. So we are, for every topic that we have given you, there are going to be 1, 2, or 3 videos which you need to watch. Related to each video lecture, there will be activities that are prescribed. Some of these activities are individual activities. Some of these are group activities. You may be asked to form groups of 3 or 4, or maybe the entire college as a group. So please take responsibility in forming these groups and completing these group activities. Sometimes coordinators may have to step in and play a role in ensuring that groups are formed. Even though you may not be given marks or assigned grades for these activities, it is extremely important that you carry out these activities, because these are the kind of skills that we acquire through practice. So Professor Sethi was earlier talking about the importance of practice. So we cannot stress this enough, that these are not topics that you can learn only by listening to lectures or by reading. It is only through practice that we can learn more about this. So please ensure that you complete these activities and do them as many times as possible, as many times as you want to do them. In addition, we will be giving you some assignments. So some of these assignments may not be mandatory, some of them may be mandatory. So we will let you know which ones are mandatory. So it's important that you complete these assignments and submit them to us. We will tell you how to submit them in time. Reading, again, Professor Sethi gave you specific tips about how to enhance your reading activities over the next 1 month. So a range of material is going to be made available to you to read about each of the topics. Again, these are not topics on which we have formally learned earlier as part of our respective programs. So you may not be able to understand and get the gist of what is being explained in these readings. So, number one, please make an effort to read them as seriously as possible. Number two, please contact your respective coordinators if you cannot understand any of these. And number three, please get back to us through the discussion forum if you cannot understand something or if you want something to be explained to you. For each of the modules, we are going to be giving you some additional links to other videos that are available via internet. So some of these are from outside of India, but many of these are going to be from within India also. So please ensure that you watch these videos and learn from them. And finally, for each module, we'll be giving you quizzes. So it's extremely important that you complete these quizzes, because only then will you be given your certificates. While doing all of these from point 1 to point 5, as Professor Sethi stressed and emphasized in the morning, we expect you to follow an honor code. That is, we are not going to be doing any policing. There's no surveillance, there's no camera, there's nobody to check with you and ask you whether you've completed these. But you have volunteered for this course, and some of you have told us why you have chosen to register for this course, because you expect to learn. So we expect that you will respect yourself and complete all these activities, that you will not copy the quiz answers from somebody else, because in that case you are not respecting other people. So each and every one of you, please respect yourselves and ensure that you complete all these tasks as seriously as possible. Okay, I hope all of you promise this to yourselves and to your neighbors, whoever is sitting next to you. I just want to spend a couple of minutes on the assignment that I've already given to you for the first introductory lecture. So all of you must have seen the video by now. Along with the video, we have given you some links to other videos. We have given you links to external reading on the internet. And then I have given you a set of assignments. I would like you to do all three assignments as seriously as possible. If you cannot understand any of these, please speak to your coordinators or get back to us through the discussion forum. So I'm going to explain this assignment to you, the activities that we have prescribed for you. One, because you are still students, you're not yet in the workplace, you may not quite understand what is meant by workplace communication skills. So I would like each of you to talk to your family members, talk to relatives, friends, neighbors who are already working. Ask them questions. What skills did they acquire after joining the organization? And what kind of workplace skills were most difficult to acquire? If you can know this, you are already better prepared in terms of acquiring workplace communication skills, right? The second activity that I would like you to do is to talk to the person in charge of placement in your college or university. Please ask him or her which kind of workplace communication skills are most sought by the companies that come for recruitment. Ask them which kind of communication skills are lacking in a majority of the students. Check for yourself what are your strengths, what are your weaknesses, and see what you need to improve. Finally, after watching the introductory video and the PPT that is attached to that, go to the topics that we have given you. Create two columns next to these topics. Number one, find out what is your skill level on each of these topics. Give yourself a grade: excellent, good, or needs improvement. Create one more column on the right side and note down if you have written needs improvement for any of these topics, what steps are you going to take to enhance your skills? What are you going to do to enhance your skills on any of these modules? Okay. Now, if you can prepare this chart, you will again be much better prepared in terms of learning and benefiting from all of these modules, because you need to take personal interest in trying to understand what is it that you are good at, what is it that needs improvement for you. You can then decide how much time to allot in terms of improving your skills for specific kinds of modules. Okay, do I have your promise on all of these? Anurag Group of Institutions. So do your students have any questions for us?
My name is Venkatesh Varlu. I am mechanical third year. So like, what all will we learn after the course, like after the ending of this course? So like, we don't know any workplace communication skills, like we are not doing any job. So like, how can we, you told that we can't see and we can't study and learn, we can see and learn more. So how will you make sure that we'll learn?
Okay, so that's very important and useful question to ask, because you will have access to certain kinds of learning during this course, but you will not get a chance to practice because you're not working right now. So what we are going to do is to design certain activities for you which you can practice on your own, okay, which you can practice on your own with your own friends. But we can also try to set up interactions in workplaces in some cities where you can actually go and get an experience. So I would suggest that your coordinator can address this question. Your coordinator can get people who are working in organization in your own cities to come and speak to you about this. But maybe some of you can also go to workplaces in your own organizations and spend some time, find out how they communicate. Use your skills in communicating with them and see if they actually work or there are problems in using those communication skills that you have acquired in this course. Okay? But we'll see what we can do from our end.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Can we go to another college? D.Y. Patil in Pune. Hello.
I am the course coordinator, Vaishali Biradar, from D.Y. Patil. Participants, ask you the questions regarding the workplace.
So my name is Rajeshwari, and sir, I am a third year engineering student.
So I wanted to ask that during we interact with people, like it's informal, formal. So respecting yourself and others, how do we do it in like in regular manner?
Okay, that's a very interesting question. Okay, so this is something that we think that we all grow up knowing how to respect others as human beings. But sometimes society teaches us the opposite also. So how to overcome that, that's extremely important, because in a workplace, whether you like each other or not, you have to work with each other. Okay, and it becomes easier if you respect each other. So how do you gain respect for the other? First and most basic thing is to put yourself in the shoes of other people. Okay, try and see things from other people's perspectives. So you have particular perspective, you have some views, you have some opinions, and there is a disagreement with what other people say, whether it could be about how to achieve a goal, what kind of strategies to follow. So best thing is to put yourself in the shoes of others and see and try and understand things from their perspective. So there are a number of psychological techniques and activities which help us to see things from other people's perspectives. But beyond that, in this course, what we are going to do is to focus on how to respect other people, firstly in terms of how they contribute to the objectives of an organization. Secondly, how to respect them in terms of their own individuality. That everybody has a unique individuality. They also have a unique cultural context. They are male or female or third gender, or maybe they belong to different religions, language groups, regions with different educational backgrounds and so on. But each of them has something to contribute to the organization. So recognizing that they have something to contribute, they have certain unique skills, but also that each of them needs to be respected for what they are. Once we understand this, it becomes easy to respect other people. But the first point that you mentioned is also extremely important. Please remember to respect yourself also. Okay, don't give up too easily. Don't think that you are inferior. The very fact that you've come up to this place in this institution shows the kind of ability that you have. And the fact that you've registered for this course shows that you want to enhance your own self-esteem and self-respect. Because communication, soft skills, these are about enhancing our respect for ourselves, our self-esteem. Okay? So the moment that you recognize that you have something to contribute and that I need to be respected, I need to be given a chance, I need to be given an opportunity to showcase my talents, my skills, then you develop respect for yourself. Okay? So in an organization, it's important that you fight for your own self-esteem and self-respect so that you can grow as an individual, but do the same for others. That's an important part of what modern workplaces are about. Okay? Yeah. So thank you very much. Yes.
Thank you so much, sir. We'll be looking forward to be meeting you again.
Thank you. We look forward to having you as well.
This is Sujata Madam from D.Y. Patil, Pimpri, Pune. Sir, I really appreciate the answer you gave to my students. Understanding others, you have to be in their shoes. So this is something that will really make them think. Isn't it, students? Yes. And sir, I would also like to congratulate you and thank you for the lovely coordination and communication you are having with the students. It was really great talking to you, sir. We look forward to you henceforth.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Sujata Madam, for coordinating a lovely batch of students. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
So, we would like to wind up now because we've just gone beyond the deadline given to us. But I'm sure a lot of you will have questions and clarifications, and you can share that with us via the discussion forum. But please don't go away just yet. Just hold on for a couple of minutes, because Dr. Kalpana Kannan, who's the manager for this course, would like to give you some instructions.
We just now got the figure that it's around 25,000 students. So nowhere in the world people are doing such big activity where at one go we can reach out to 25,000 students. So I'm really happy about it, and thanks for participating in large numbers, and we are doing our best in IIT Bombay to cater to your needs, and we have excellent professors here who will help you and guide you, and we have an excellent back-end team who is working day and night to make this happen. So it is not, so you can imagine how much work would have gone into this to, and I have my colleague Mahendra Parmar.
So so there are a whole lot of people who are working behind the scene. So we have a studio team, we have a workshop team, we have a content team, we have
teaching assistant.
Yeah, teaching assistant. So there's a whole lot of people who are working behind this. So I just want you to know that we are a big team here, and that's why we are able to deliver this program to you. So there are certain things which I want everybody to know, that I know that you all have registered on a website, which is the College to Cooperate website, but you have to also register on IIT Bombay X using the same email ID. So unless you do that, you won't be able to see the online component. That is the MOOC platform which we are using for the courses. So please register on IIT Bombay X platform using the same email ID that you have used to register on the College to Cooperate. And we are going to open the registration till September 12th. So that is the hard deadline. So we don't want anybody to say later on that we didn't know about this. So please ask your friends or other people to register before September 12th. So September 12th is the last day for registration. And now we might be rescheduling, as Professor Sethi said. We are still working out on how to make the content available to you on the platform. So there could be some rearrangement of the schedule. So we will update it on the platform. So the schedule, please check the schedule. So there will be weekly release. So the weekly release, initially we thought we'll do it on Thursdays, but now because people are saying that if we are meeting on Saturday, then it will be better if we release it on Tuesday. Okay. So it could be that we will release the next set of content on September 12th instead of September 14th. So please check your IIT Bombay X website, and then you'll be able to know what are the changes. Mm-hmm. So most probably from now on, it will be every Tuesday we'll release the content, and there will be deadline for all the quizzes, weekly quizzes. So it is you'll get at least 3 days. Sometimes it could be more. So the each week there will be quiz deadlines. So please stick to the quiz deadlines. And if you have any queries, please post them on discussion forum. So for the first time, if you are using the platform, you may find a little difficult. But I suggest everybody should go through the demo, IIT Bombay X demo course. So that will give you guidelines like how to use the platform. So please register on the demo course, IIT Bombay X demo course. Go through that course. It will hardly take 1 hour or 2 hours of your time. So please go through that demo course so that you have an idea how to use the platform, because the MOOC platform is quite different from what you have been using. So it will be beneficial if you register for the demo course and take that course. And discussion forum is available to you. So if you have any queries, please post them on discussion forum. We have set of teaching assistants who will answer your queries on the discussion forum. So there is also an announcement for the course coordinators. So we request you to take a snapshot of your classroom and mail it to eoutreach@it.iitb.ac.in. So this is a request from Professor Fatak, because he wants to send it to the ministry and to tell a lot of people that how we are able to reach out to so many people. So please, I request all of you, all the course coordinators, to take a snapshot of your classroom and send it to eoutreach@it.iitb.ac.in.
Classroom with the students sitting there.
Yeah, with the student, of course. And attendance, I think already a mail has gone from the course team, like how for each online session you should take the attendance of your students. And yeah, so if you cannot upload it on the platform, you can send it. So you can send it offline. So it was really nice. I think we have started with a very good note, and I really congratulate and appreciate the efforts taken by all the remote center coordinators as well as the course coordinators. I'm really happy to see that so many people have registered, and
the program has just begun, and we will be interacting with you often and through the platform as well as the face-to-face. So the next face-to-face interaction will be on 23rd September. Please note the date. So it's on Saturday, and it will be a full day thing. So from 9:30 to 5:30 with a break, with a lunch break. So morning will be soft skills, and afternoon will be workplace communication. So thanks a lot. And so we look forward to working with you and for the next 8 weeks. Thank you.